In this video we will show you how to import STL files into a job. Let's load the already created disk from the blank archive. Now the import view displays. Here we first select an STL file. The preview window gives you a three-dimensional view of the selected file. Now we must specify the calculation options. First, we select the indication from the list. In our case, the object is a fully anatomical crown. Now we choose the processing quality for the selected STL. A high processing quality is achieved by smaller path distances when finishing outer surfaces. Smaller path distances lead to smoother surfaces, but also to an increased processing time. The surface quality of the cavities is not affected by this setting. With this icon you can deactivate, or activate the feature, Detect Cavities. If we activate the feature, Detect Cavities, the software will automatically detect the cavity of the crown, including the preparation line. With this icon, we can deactivate or activate the detection of drillings. As our selected STL file has no drillings, we deactivate this feature, so that DentalCam will not spend time searching for non-existent drillings. When all calculation options have been specified, you can add the STL to the import list. Your STL now appears on the import list. Now we will add a second STL file, a reduced coping. Since a reduced coping has no detailed fissures, we'll choose the indication crown bridge less detailed from the list. With this selection, the processing time for the object is shorter, as it is not processed with fine fissure tools. In addition, this object does not require very smooth outer surfaces, so we can select the fast quality for this object. This will save time and reduces tool wear. The settings for the detection of cavities and drillings remain the same. Now we can add our second object to the import list. The green indicators tell us that the height of our disc is sufficient for the height of the crowns. If one of the indicators displayed in red, we would simply go back to the blank archive and create a blank with a suitable height. Time to add the objects to the job. DentalCam will now automatically open the nesting view. This is the next step in our workflow. We hope that this was helpful. Thank you for watching.